Hello, brothers and sisters in Christ. I hope you are doing good today. Today, I am going to discuss and illustrate to you a lesson from 1 John chapter 5, verse 1 to 5, and using some simple visual aid and a personal experience. So let me start illustrating this topic by using a story from my personal experience. Let me start with something that I wrote. When I started going to church here in Austin, Texas, I'm also a new immigrant to the United States. And it is a very new situation and it's a very new environment for me. And it is quite nerve-wracking. With in turn, I'm also a new Christian at that time, new to the faith, new found Christ, and new found Lord. And I'm always interested on knowing how to know God more, but I'm always hesitant to actually pursue it. One of those days, my pastor assigned me to a Bible study group near my place. And as I started going to that group, I felt so shy and I felt a loss of confidence. Being very new, and as my culture says, I'm always very shy too. And I feel so overwhelmed and I doubted my ability to be around these seasoned Christians. However, as I began attending this study group, more and more, my Bible study leader took care of me and guided me all throughout my journey. He prayed for me consistently, believed in my potential, and my perspective has changed from time. His encouragement to really know more about God and really working hard for it, pray harder, and read the Bible and meditate upon God's word the hardest, really took a very significant springboard for my faith. It made my belief in God much deeper. And in turn, being able to believe in myself and help me overcome my fears and doubts. And now, I'm on this degree now to really pursue a degree in biblical counseling because I want to continue what my Bible study leader had shown me, showing the love of God to our fellow believers and in turn, also following His commandments and obedience to His commandments, which is the lesson for our topic today, which is believing in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and then you're gonna be born of God, and then you're gonna be loving God, and then you're gonna love fellow believers, and in turn you're gonna have obedience in God's commandments. Let me show it to you in a visual aid. The experience mirrors the truth in 1 John 5, 1 to 5, as I said a while ago, which is beautifully illustrated on this visual aid. Believe in Jesus Christ is the starting point, much like trusting my Bible study leader. You see the emphasis in there. Believe in Jesus Christ, in Jesus, and then in turn it will go somewhere. This belief leads to being born of God, giving me and you a new identity and strength. From that arrow, you will see that you will be born of God. Born of God. You will be of God now and not of this world. And in turn, it will actually go somewhere else again. Being born of God and having this identity we will have the flow to know the love for God, just as my newfound confidence led me to respect and trust my Bible study leader and my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, through the Bible study leader's guidance. So knowing and being born of God, in turn, you will have the love for God. Believe, born of God flows for the love for God. You have the love for God now. Your priority is really knowing and loving God. And in turn, naturally, it always extends to the love for fellow believers, creating a supportive community similar to the study group community that I experience. So, knowing God, loving God, being born of God, extends to loving your fellow believers, our fellow believers. Love for God extends to love for believers. And in turn, both of those loving for God and loving our fellow believers leads to obedience to God's commandments. Both love for God and love for our fellow believers leads to obedience to God's commands. And the thing is, most of us will think that loving God, loving fellow believers, and obedience to God's commandments is burdensome and it's really hard. But that is a significant lie, because knowing that you have this love for God turns your obedience to something that is not just of yourself, but with the guidance of God. Because this is rooted out of love and faith, allowing us to overcome any world challenges that we experience each and every day. Just as I overcome my struggles adapting to a newfound faith and community here in the United States. I hope that simple illustration and simple visual aid has led you to understand that believing in Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, being born of God, loving for God, loving our fellow believers, always ends in the obedience on God's commandment. That's like what it said in the verse, the greatest commandment is loving God and loving others. Thank you for listening, and God bless us all.